on 9/11, I was on ABC being interviewed by Diane Sawyer when the first plane hit the first tower and she broke through. I was there. So I wandered the street that day and I saw all these people walking around covered in soot, and I would see these ladies walking by themselves crying, and I just knew that, you know, we were seeing people that had lost their whole life that day, you know. And I was back with my family a year and a half later, and I thought, I'm sure there are a lot of people that are still wandering the streets from that day, you know, people day hasn't ended yet.
Charlie Fireman, hey!
I did a lot of research and a lot of reading and a lot of talking with therapists and people that had lost spouses and fathers. We talked to a lot of people because I didn't want to dwell on 9/11 or any kind of sensational kind of thing. I always knew this was a story about friendship and the people that were left and who was in their life. At the soul of the movie is a story of two men who don't have anyone to talk to. And as the movie progresses, they have each other to talk to, and they just, some of the best scenes of the movie is the two of them just unloading.
You know what it is? Janine and I are just up under each other too much. She's always asking me to open up, you know, and talk to her, and then I do. And everything gets so personal, and the whole thing just goes to shit.
I think they both become a lifeline for each other, you know, a chance for both of them to just kind of go on with their lives and make their lives work, you know. There's really something to be said to having a really good friend. I know that works for me in my life. I feel that when I'm have people that I'm really honest with and that really know me, I just feel more in my life.
Hey, Charlie, you don't mind if Donna stays and has some pizza, right?
Oh, yeah, you can stay.
Let's go. There's some plates in the kitchen.
Thank you, Dr. Johnson, for everything.
Oh, okay.
One of the reasons Alan is able to get through to Charlie when no one else is because Alan never knew his wife and three kids. He knew him really well before he had a wife and three kids, and then they split up after college and they lost track of each other. And when they meet again, subconsciously, he feels safe around Alan because he knows that Alan isn't going to bring up a lot of old stories about the wife and the kids, and he's not going to ask him because he doesn't know anything about him. It's what Sugarman says to him. Says, you know, I was his golfing buddy. I knew his family. We vacationed together. He wants nothing to do with me. He likes you, Alan. You know why?
Why?
It's very simple. Because you know nothing about Doreen and Jenny and Julie and Gina. Or Spider, the family poodle. You know nothing about them, so he figures you won't ask any questions. He figures you'll just let him be. Now, how funny is this? That you're up here wanting me to help out in yet another fruitless campaign to get Charlie to see a shrink. The one guy he figures would just let him be. And that becomes, like, I think, at least from a writing point of view, the thing that made Cheadle's character the most appealing to Adam's character.
Call me or have Alan call me and we'll schedule something. Donna, hi.
I'm early.
Yeah,
Dr. Johnson.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm fine.
I'm early.
Okay.
You're always looking for actors that can bring comedy. There's a lot of big laughs in this movie that Cheadle and Sandler, believe it or not, Adam Sandler can bring comedy to a movie. I know that surprises people.
The new champion.
No, you were in there with me. It's what you said in the restaurant. Oh. See, that's old College Johnson. That's kicking the shit, Johnson.
I was thinking about another guy we know. Handelman, Andrew Handelman. He didn't take shit from nobody.
Yeah.
You used to take shit from everybody, though. Remember that?
I love the character that Sandler created. He's just so, it's such an original to me. I love the way he walks. I love the way when him and Cheadle fight about the who's going to play guitar and who's going to play drums. And Sandler says to Cheadle, you'll get to these. Just sit down. He's just got a great, kind of, he's the friend you always wanted to have, you know, and there's a humility about that character that makes me laugh.
I'm gonna go take a walk.
Say hi to Charlie.
Don't do that. Don't act like you know what I'm... Did I say I was going over to Charlie's? Don't do that. You're not in my head.
I laugh at Cheadle's inability to talk sometimes. You know, when he wants to say something to his wife and keeps walking in and out. And...
Send him my love.
See, you want... and if I then... Okay.
The problem with Cheadle's marriage is not that he's thinking about other women. And the problem with Adam's life is that he can't stop thinking about one woman who's gone. They're not looking to get drunk. They're not looking to cause trouble. They're not looking to get laid. They just want to have a good time with each other. And I think that that whole section of the movie is a section of the movie the audience likes for that reason. To see adults just want to have fun.
You gotta stab in the right spot.
I'm stabbing it right there.
You gotta be on the light. Stab. Shit. That's not gonna
now
work.
See? I gotta climb this big son of a bitch.
Look, just put it down, all right? Rest. Next time you come over, you'll be even better. You gotta let it all soak in.
No. There's right now. No next. Now.
I thought you don't have an addictive personality. That was the line of the night, man. You're an addict. Say it, man. Say you're an addict.
Okay, I'm an addict.
I think actors trust me a little bit more because I'm an actor and they've seen me acting over the years. I also think that as a writer, I hope I'm putting something in my characters that's speaking to them. I don't want someone to do it because of the money or because this would be a good career move. I'm looking for an actor who says, you know, something about this part is touching me in a way that I want to use this to do more of the work that I do.
They want to have you committed. They want to have the right to hold on to you for up to a year. That's what they're saying. The hospital staff is recommending it as well, and the Templemans, they're on board with it too.
Templemans? Can we go get Chinese now?
I knew that Adam and Don were going to really work when I saw how much they liked each other. They have a lot of similar qualities and similar interests. You know, they're both really athletic. They're both really good musicians. They're both really incredibly intelligent and talented guys. I knew long before we even started rehearsing that they were going to work together. They had a chemistry.
You tell her you can't do that.
No, I know.
You tell her you're married?
She knows. It's not a deterrent for this one. I mean, she's got some kind of a fixation or something.
Oh, well, fix it for her.
It's not funny, Charlie.
No.
It's really not funny. I mean, yeah. My partners are up my ass.
Right.
No, we already pay an obscene amount in liability insurance.
She tell your partners they can do to you what the girl wants to do. Fuck them.
When I wanted to tell the story, I really wanted to tell it from the point of view of a man on the streets and on the sidewalks living with this horrible hop of the ball after 9/11. There's no big sweeping shots in this movie. Everything is done down from the sidewalk's point of view to really just have the movie and the characters skim across the sidewalks in New York and be inside the canyons of the buildings and not above them ever. Because I think that when you do spend your life in the city, you are inside those giant walls of buildings everywhere you go. And a lot of those canyons kind of speak to the rut that Charlie's in. So that was interesting. And because we shot on the Genesis cameras, which were these new high-def cameras that Panavision has, we didn't have to light the world at night. Our depth of field was so much further that you could see, you know, blocks and blocks in the distance. I think that overall, even though you don't notice it, the net result as you watch the movie is you really feel that you're inside the city of New York and you're not you know, someone outside watching a movie about New York. And I think that gives it a whole different look.
I'm weary of the nights I've seen inside these empty halls.
So, Charlie, I wanted to go back to where we were last week. You were telling me that there's some things that you don't like to think about. Do you think you could give me an example of some of those things?
As Liv came on board, we kind of created this backstory to the character. She's someone who's not really confident in her own ability. At the same time, she wants to help, she wants to heal. And she was great.
I have this odd sense of intimacy towards you. I don't even know why.
Yeah.
I told my shrink about it and she said I should act on it.
Oh, she did? Well, you need to get a new shrink. Get several and get a new dentist too. You gotta get out of here, Mr. Remar.
Saffron Burroughs is just an amazing actress. I mean, she's seriously one of the best looking women on the planet. There was an awkwardness about her, you know, that really works well.
Alan, where have you been? I've been calling you for the last 3 hours.
Jade, it was my first choice and I just called her up and just said, you know, if you want this role, it's yours.
Alan, I need you to listen to me. Your father's died.
What?
And I've been trying to reach you.
What'd she just say?
There's something special about her, and I knew that she was going to be able to bring a lot to the role. The women in this movie are really incredible.
It is time for you to stop all the...
Well, music's always been important to me my whole life, you know. I just love music. I always have. You know, everything I do is written to certain kinds of music, and I know that people hold on to music from a certain era, a certain part of their life. And this was a character that had this tragedy, and he didn't want to deal with not only the part of his life he's in, but the part of his life where he had his wife and children. So he went way back, kind of was like hiding in this era of music that was so important to him. He just becomes obsessive about collecting the albums of his youth. I wrote the script for Rain Over Me. It's about someone who doesn't have anyone to talk to. And I wanted the movie to have that same type of feel, that kind of joyous pain. Audiences love this movie, and it makes me happy because I love how hard they laugh throughout the movie, and then they start crying. And then they're laughing and they're crying, and they come out and they're just really touched, really moved, and I love that.
I don't need to talk about it or look at pictures, because the truth is, a lot of times I see it on the street. I walk down a street, I see her in someone else's face. Clearer than any of the pictures you carry with you. I get that you're in pain, but you got each other. You got each other. And I'm the one who's got to see her and the girls all the time, everywhere I go. I even see the dog.
That's how fucked up I still am. I look at a German Shepherd, I see our goddamn poodle.
Everything I do, I start as a comedy. You know, I'm always looking to do a comedy. I'm always looking for the comedy, you know? They just come out with these dark themes sometimes, and, you know, I don't like comedy that doesn't feel real, so sometimes I go to a place that's so real, but I've never set out, I'm gonna write a drama. I always start out and go, I'm gonna write a funny piece about a guy who lost his family and is trying to rebuild his life, you know? The whole movie distills down to a movie about communication. You know, it's about two people that don't know how to communicate. And the two most important lines in the movie are when Liv Tyler says to Don,
I think it would be really good for you to talk to someone. I just sense that it would be good for you to be a little bit more communicative.
And then when she says to Adam,
but you need to tell someone your story. It doesn't have to be me, but someone.
That's the whole movie to me. That the whole movie just boils down to that aspect of it.